Today we're going to connect Snowflake to AWS S3, basically following the directions in here. This is option two. This method is deprecated, but it is still used occasionally in dev and test environments or for quick proof of concepts. Option one on top of this is the recommended way. So here, let's show you what it's going to look like. This is going to fail, and that's fine because it doesn't exist. But let me show you an example of what does exist. And at the end of our tutorial, this will work. So you could write ls or list, kind of like the Unix command. As you can see, these are the objects within my S3. And then from there, I could see the size, MD5 last modified. If I wanted to peer into one of these files, I'm just going to grab this one at random. And select $1, $2, $3. That just says the first three columns. If I wanted $4, that'll give me the fourth column, so on and so forth. So you can see these files before you load it in. So the benefits here are massively parallel and quick loading of files from S3, and also the option to delete files after loading using the rm command if you wanted to. Okay. And so we're going to create a S3 bucket, IAM policy, and user. And that's on the AWS side, and the Snowflake, we're going to create a stage. Now, I'm using everything that I create will have a temp 171 suffix. If you wanted to just find and replace and do the same to make it your own unique name, that's totally fine and recommended because this must be a globally unique name. Okay, so let's create a bucket, create an S3 bucket. So here, I'm going to create an S3 bucket, call it Snowflake. Temp 171. Okay, Snowflake temp 171, good. And you're gonna want it in the same region as your Snowflake. So mine is in US West, my Snowflake is in US West, so my bucket's gonna be in US West Oregon as well. The benefit of that is it's faster and you have less data transfer costs. So you just hit create. Okay, so we have that Snowflake temp 171 bucket. Now let's move on to step two. We're going to be in identity and access management now. We're gonna be in the policies on the left sidebar, and we're gonna create policy. So you hit create policy, and then we'll go to the JSON tab right here. And we're gonna paste the script from this website right here. So let's go to this website. This just happens to be my GitHub, and let's copy and paste this script in. This is the permissions that we're going to give this bucket. So we're going to put our bucket name in these two locations where it says replace with your bucket name. Okay. So the bucket name that we had here was Snowflake temp 171. We're just going to put that in here. Okay, so before we hit review, let's see what this is doing. It's going to allow us to put object, which is add an object, get objects, and delete objects within this folder, the folder that we just created. Any objects, that's what that star means within there. So any additional folders or files that you put in there, and it allows you to see the list bucket, to see the contents of it. And we're going to hit review policy. Give it a policy name. Let's go back to our script over here. So we replace the ready review policy, add our name. Yeah, you call it whatever you want. I'm gonna call it Snowflake policy temp 171. And then you can hit create policy. Oh, the entity already exists, that's fine. So I'll just call this B. All right. Okay. Create user and attach policy. So we're going to go to IAM again and users right here. We're going to hit add user and whatever you want to call it. I'm just going to call mine Snowflake temp 171, and we're going to give it programmatic access. And we hit next. So we're going to attach existing policies directly. And we're going to filter on Snowflake and find the policy that we just created. That was the one with the policy temp B in my case. We're going to hit next. Next again. And then we're going to create a user. Okay. So let's just keep this handy because we're going to let's just copy the access ID. We're going to use this in, right here. So now we've done step 1, 2, and 3. We're going to create a stage. So we've pretty much done everything we need to on the Snowflake side. Now we're going to need to create what we need on the Snowflake side. I mean, we finished what we need on the AWS side. We're going to create what we're going to need on the Snowflake side. So here we're going to replace foo and bar with our. So AWS key ID is this access key ID in AWS. So we're going to put that value there. Yours is going to be something different. And then the secret key is what's over here. So I'm going to show it. I don't mind if you see mine because I'm going to delete this immediately afterwards, but you're going to want to keep this confidential. All right. So I'm going to create this stage. All right. And then this should work. Yep. So as you can see, I can see into my S3, and anything that I put in there will also work. Let me just scroll back to the top. Remember this command failed in the beginning. It's going to work now. All right. So there you go. And then any file that you drop into your S3 or any folders, you'll be able to run the select just like this one that we have over here against that name. Okay. Thank you.